Let's take a look now at how a government will be formed tonight for a breakdown on the number of seats each side needs to win. I'm joined by Nerelda Jacobs, who's got the best view in the House tonight. G'day, Nerelda. What's the state of play?
Kai, Sandra, I sure do have the best view of the House. The House of Reps, that is. Let's see where it's all at. There are 151 seats in the House. 76 seats are needed to win government. And let's take you back to the 2019 election result, where the Coalition won 77 seats, convincing a majority government, Labor falling short with 68 seats. But it didn't stay that way. In the last 3 years, there was a redistribution which saw the Liberal seat of Stirling in WA scrapped and redistributed to Victoria, where the seat of Hawke was created in safe Labor territory. As well, we all remember Craig Kelly when Craig defected from the Coalition and then joined Clive Palmer's United Australia Party. So that redistribution and the defection saw the Morrison government lose two seats and Labor gain one seat. The Coalition is going into this election with 75 seats, not the 77 they had in 2019, while Labor's gain of the seat of Hawke has it sitting at 69 seats. So the challenge for Anthony Albanese is to retain all of those 69 seats and pick up at least seven more to reach that magical number of 76 seats to form majority government. But if Labor picks up an extra five, then Albanese can still form a minority government. Been enjoying the speculation so far from the panel of the rise and fall of the seat. So keep it up. The best election coverage in Australia is happening right here.